Because I don't know, maybe like for 4th of July. Today I'm making a video that I wish had existed when I started purchasing luxury items, a dedicated video to one brand and my opinion on the quality of that brand. Obviously, today's gonna be about Gucci. This is the fashion house that I own the most products from. Everything I'm gonna talk about today are accessories. And please don't think this is me bragging and being like, look at me, look what I have. That's not what this is at all. Owning these things is hard work, you know? It takes a lot of hard work to save up money for luxury items. So if I can be helpful for you guys and help you save money and not waste things on items that maybe you thought you needed and now after watching my video, maybe you think you don't, I just wanna be helpful, okay? I'm not a braggart, I swear. Let's go ahead and just get started. I gotta stop talking. So I'm gonna start with my favorite items and then go to my least favorite items. So this is my favorite, all-time favorite, hands down Gucci purchase I've ever made. This is my Queen Margaret top handle bag. I love her. I could never say more positive things about her. I've had this bag for maybe 3 years. I don't remember. I got this bag from the Gucci Wooster location in Soho. It was literally like brand new. I think it had opened up that month. The general manager helped us and a sales associate helped us, and they were so kind. I knew that I wanted to see this. I had been seeing the Queen Margaret motif on everyone. Billy Porter was wearing it in American Horror Story. Petra Collins was wearing it for the Gucci Bloom fragrance campaign, and they had wallets, they had belts, they just had everything, and I love bees. I would call this like a well-planned impulse purchase because I wasn't sure if I was gonna buy it, but I knew when I saw it in person that it had to be mine. So right now I have the top handle covered in a Gucci Flora Twilly. I love this Twilly. It holds up so well. It doesn't wrinkle. I love Gucci Twillies, but the bag itself is it's just great. The quality of the leather is there. I would say that I'm gentle to this bag, but you hit stuff, you can't really help it, and it's not really scratched up. I do need to buy like a leather cleaner because it is so smooth that it will show like fingerprints. Gotta take the pads out of the purse, Anna, and your pills. What I really love though is how much room I get in here. I can fit everything I need to and more in this bag. Technically, it has four pockets. It's got the two main ones here, and then these little small ones here, and then a zipper in the back. It's a great bag. The only thing that I don't love about this bag is this ugly strap that came with it. I didn't like care about the strap that much because I knew I wouldn't be using it, but like, I don't know. I love you, Alessandro Michele, but that season, I think he came out with like this red, white, and blue striped like new take on the web design, and it was on a couple of things. It's just not me. It doesn't go with anything that I own, so I never use this. And it's really unfortunate that Gucci does not sell individual crossbody straps. So if I ever want to carry it crossbody, I'm gonna have to buy it from another brand. Regardless of the strap, it's my all-time favorite handbag, and I want to have her forever. Keeping in theme with handbags, you know I've got this bag. Who doesn't have this bag? This is the Gucci Marmont small shoulder bag. I bought this right when it became the it bag. I bought this because everybody had it, but I will give it to Gucci that this is probably one of the best quality bags I've ever had. It's not exactly in style anymore. They do have the new spring collection and the really beautiful pastel like spring shades with silver hardware, but the black and gold hardware was classic. And I will say that I got every penny's worth out of this bag. When I tell you that I carried it everywhere, I carried it everywhere. This thing is so durable. For me, having this bag for probably 4 years, it looks amazing. The only negative thing about this bag is that on the corners here, you can see the webbing sort of coming out. But honestly, I've had this bag for so long and every other aspect of it looks really great. It is still holds its shape when I take everything out of it. And the leather is it's really great quality leather. I love that I can wear this front and back. Sometimes you just don't want to have a bag with, brand on the front. So I would wear it this way. And yeah, you can still see like the Gucci G's, but it's a little more demure this way. But I just found this bag to be really versatile. and it went with a lot, and I really did get my money's worth out of this bag. Now, is it on trend anymore? I would say if you want a really good basic bag that you know that you could probably get an investment like price, like you would get, I would say maybe 60 to 75% of your money's worth back, maybe, because they are continuing to make bags in this shape now, and I still see people carrying this bag. Yeah, go for it. It's just not, it's just a little overdone for me now. I will wear it for work because it's just a really good bag to like throw your things in and go. It's crossbody, it just works. It's a comfortable bag. The body strap is also very generous. So if you are curvy like me, it will fall about right at your hip. I'm 5'2", I am not tall at all. So if you're taller, maybe it'll be a little shorter than that. But my overall review of the bag is that it was worth the money. I do not regret buying it. I was just ready for something new. And I've had this bag for a really long time. It just like, it still smells like leather and it is disgusting. Look at everything I have in there. I need to be better about my bags. Another thing to be aware of too is that the gold has rubbed off like a little bit on the highest points of the G's. I'm not sure if you can see, but it's tarnished just a little bit. It's honestly not that noticeable unless I'm like staring at it like that. The zipper has never given me trouble. The leather has become really pliable and very soft. The edges of the strap aren't really that frayed compared to other brands of like the decay the straps go through. This is pretty impressive. I will give them that. So I do not think that this is a problem. I like that these look a little worn, you know? I mean, Louis Vuitton people, they love the fact that their handles get patinaed. So I don't really care about that. Like I said, I think that I really did get my money's worth out of this bag. Am I gonna be wearing it like all the time anymore? No, it's had its moment. But again, I do not regret buying it. And I do think that Gucci leather quality is very nice. So if you are looking for a bag that you're gonna have for a long time, you can use it and abuse it like I have. I've not been super kind to this bag in the last year or so and it still looks this way, I would say go for it because it is very durable. At the same time that I bought her, I bought my Marmont wallet. So I got the wallet in this like nudie blushy pink shade because I thought that it would just like match everything. And it kind of does. The wallets are made out of the same leather that the handbags are. The wear and tear on the wallet has not fared as well as the wear and tear on the handbag, but that's probably just because it gets like hit a lot more. And honestly, I just like throw this thing in my bags. I really like haven't been, you know, I haven't treated this one that nicely. So you can see that the varnish on the GG's is a little bit more worse for wear. And you can see where the closure is. It looks a little bit beat up. But honestly, for having this wallet for as long as I've had it, it doesn't really look that bad. I could easily go in with like a leather cleaner and it looked pretty much as good as new. Even the corners aren't horrible. They're just discolored. They're not damaged at all. So again, going in line with the handbags, Gucci leather is really nice and very worth the money. Keeping on theme with leather. So these are my ankle boots from Gucci with the Sylvie web design, which is this strap that's supposed to go around the boot here. Again, red, white, and blue, not for me. So I don't wear that. I just wear the boots on their own. I love a piece that makes you feel different. And you know what I mean when I say that boots that look like this make you feel some type of way, you know what I'm saying? I don't have a lot of things that have this attitude, you know what I mean? And I just love them. I love that they make me feel a little more powerful or whatever, like a little bit more punky, I don't know. These are just great boots. They are heavy. They are very high quality and they are still in season. You can get them on the Gucci website. You can also find them on the RealReal too. That's where I got them. The leather right here is very nice, very pliable. It feels really nice against your shin. And the toe box is very stiff, but not the kind of stiff that squeezes it in. I honestly don't really think this is that like narrow. And I don't have big feet at all. I wear a 35 and a half and I have small feet. So these have really worked. These are a 35 and a half. But overall, the quality of them is really nice. It did come with a black pair of laces as well. So if I want to switch them out, I can. But these are really great boots. So for leather boots, I do like Gucci. Now for their other shoes, let's look at a different pair of leather shoes. So let's move into things that I don't necessarily love, but I don't really hate. So, all right, the Gucci Horsebit loafers. These are one of the most recognizable pieces from Gucci that you can get. I bought these because I thought that they would be classic, they would be comfortable, that they would go with everything. And while they are classic and they do complement pretty much any kind of like professional office wear look, they're not necessarily comfortable. The soles of these shoes are so thin that I feel like I'm walking on the floor when I'm wearing them. And while I would recommend finding like very thin like hosiery or just like tiny socks to wear with these, because when you get hot and your feet sweat in these, they become so sticky. It is very uncomfortable. And this, the leather lining inside has begun to kind of like fold up right here where like the ball of your little toe on your foot is. And it kind of like rubs against it a little bit. So they're not exactly the most comfortable shoes in the world. The quality, they're okay. They're not horrible, but they're not the best either. Like you can see the difference on the bottom of the toe box here. This one's rubbing a little bit away, whereas this one still has all of those little like nails intact. I'm not really complaining. I really have worn these quite a bit and they are classic. And going along with comfort, I will say that the heel here has this like little bit of suede that a lot of the luxury shoes have, and that is very comfortable. These never bothered the back of my foot. They always bothered more of the front of my foot. I definitely don't regret buying them at all. I just would say, you know, beware that they're not the most comfortable. You don't want to go, you know, running a marathon in these. Pete Davidson called and he wants his shoes back. These are the Gucci Ace sneakers. These are another very recognizable piece of Gucci fashion. I don't know why I bought these, because I don't know, you guys. I get my money's worth out of them. I wear them a lot, but I don't know. Sometimes I just look down at my feet and I'm like, why? Is this even me? I feel like they're not me, but I don't know. They have held up very well. These are kind of like the vision of the Ace sneakers are to be worn kind of like dirty, so I never clean them or anything. They are in the middle of comfort. They're not super uncomfortable. They're very flat on the bottom, so there's not a whole lot of support. You could probably put some inserts in here and it's fine, but they're not like my favorite, but I don't dislike them. You know, I just think the next, like if I do decide to purchase another pair of like designer tennis shoes, I think I kind of like the Alexander McQueens a little bit more, because they're like really puffy and like a little bit more tall. They have more support. I've tried those on. I'm gonna be able to continue to wear them for a really long time. So these are a good purchase. How many songs could I sing about this belt? I think every generation has its Gucci belt. This is the Marmont version. Who doesn't own this? Everybody owns this belt. And now it's just not special anymore because everyone has it. I remember having to pre-order and then verify to get this from a Gucci boutique in Saks that isn't even open anymore, because everybody was buying this. And once I bought it, I wore it all the time. Look, guys, this is like really tarnished and fading. There are like weird stains on it. The leather is really bent right here. I had to get an extra hole put in because I had lost a little bit of weight. This belt has been through the ringer, but it was worth every penny because I wore it for like 2 years straight when the popularity of this belt was like at its highest. I remember seeing Dakota Johnson wearing it. Bella Hadid wore it for her Vogue interview. Jennifer Aniston wore it in interviews. Like everybody owns this belt. I don't regret it necessarily. It's just that everybody has this belt. Now, in terms of quality, if you don't know about, maybe you want to purchase like another belt from Gucci. I have owned a different one that I have sold now. It was a Queen Margaret belt that matched the bag. I never wore it, so I sold it. The leather is just, it's great, guys. I think it's the same leather that they use for the handbags, but like I've had it for so many years and there it's not breaking on the seams. There's no damage. The only wear on it is that right here is where the belt loop is on the back, and I have a big butt, so when I sit down it kind of like goes up a little bit, and so it creases right here. But honestly, like, it still looks really good from a distance. The actual brass or dipped gold here has rubbed off quite a bit, so it definitely shows wear and tear after X amount of years of owning it. But it, a lot should be said for the leather and this quality here. It's very impressive. So if you are interested in getting one, I really like the Dionysus belts. They're a little bit more unique, a little bit more like fashionable. Like, you could wear those over dresses and whatnot, whereas this is more of like your daily belt. I don't really wear it that much anymore. I wear it for work sometimes, but like I said, the leather is good quality. It was worth the money because I wore it like all the time. I need to stop. Okay, and my least favorite Gucci item are these pantyhose. I think the reason that I don't like these might differ for anyone else, because I am thick, I am not skinny, so my thighs rub together when I walk. And these, oh, they do not feel good when they are rubbing against each other. This is doubled up. This is a double layer of material, and even doubled up. It's very, very thin and webbed. I don't know how to, it's like almost like a doily, like a lace kind of a thing. They're just not as thick as like a classic pair of pantyhose. So when I wear them just on their own under a dress, they do kind of like, they just scratch the inside of my thigh a little bit. So I have layered them with a normal pair of pantyhose underneath. And the way that they stretch, you could still kind of see like the Gucci design under them. But on their own, they're just a little uncomfortable. Now, what I will say that impressed me is like the sizing on these. These are very, very stretchy and kind of big. These come up above my belly button very high whenever I wear these. So a large range of sizes can pull these off. I think they go all the way up to an extra large, but the extra large is a little harder to get your hands on. These are a large and they fit me perfect. I am in between. I never know when I'm a 12 or a 14. But when I wear these, they definitely fit. I will give it to Gucci that their size inclusivity is pretty nice with some things. Some things don't even come in like a size remotely close to me, but whatever. I can't afford a $5,000 dress anyway. And they also have the Gucci, oh God, can I see? They also have the Gucci label on the waistband. I like them. They're just not super comfortable. But if you are thin and a size like whatever, a zero or a small or extra small, your thighs don't touch when you walk, you'll probably love these. Okay guys, so that is all I have for you today on my Gucci brand accessories review, whatever I decide to end up calling this. I hope it was helpful for you, that it helped you say yes or no to some items. Let me know if you want to see like a specific brand. I'm not like rolling in cash. I don't have like a whole collection of like every brand. But if you want to see like a specific item for me to review, let me know in the comments below. Don't forget to like and subscribe and blah, blah, blah. I'll see you next time. Ew, gross.